Hello students, I hope you are doing great. Today we are going to study chapter number 13, factorization. Let us see what does factors mean. Each of the numbers has constant, whether it is a constant or a variable, which form a product is called as a factor of the product. So if I have two numbers, if I multiply it and I get a product, so that two numbers are known as factors. Say for example 5x. 5x is formed by product of 5 and x. So 5 and x are the factors of 5x. Similarly, if I multiply 2x minus 5 and 3x plus 2, I will get 2x minus 5 into 3x plus 2. So 2x minus 5 and 3x plus 2 are the factors. Now when I solve this, I will get the answer as 2x multiplied by 3x plus 2 minus 5 will be multiplied by 3x plus 2. After opening the bracket, I will get 6x square plus 4x minus 15x minus 10. xx term we will solve. So 4x minus 15x, I will get minus 11x. So we can say that 2x minus 5 and 3x plus 2 are factors of 6x square minus 11x minus 10. Because 6x square minus 11x minus 10 was obtained by multiplying 2x minus 5 and 3x plus 2. Got it? So factorization is a process of finding two or more expression whose product is equal to the given expression. Okay? Now let us see how we can find the factors. So in order to find the factorization, first we have to find the largest monomial that will be divide each term of the given polynomial completely. Second step, what we can do is divide each term of the given polynomial by this monomial. Okay, the monomial that we form. By that we will divide the given polynomial. We will get a quotient within the bracket, keeping this common monomial outside bracket. Say for example, I have 5x square minus 10x. Okay, so if we do the inspection, we know that 5x square minus 10x, the common factor is 5x. So I will keep bring this 5x outside. Okay, and inside I will write 5x square divided by 5x minus 10x divided by 5x. Okay, so 5x is multiplied and divide. Then if I solve this 5x, when I divide 5x square by 5x, what will remain? Only 1x, because 5 will get cancelled, x square upon x, you will get x. So the one thing that is remaining will be x, correct? Then 10x upon 5x, x will get cancelled, 5 1s are 5 2s are is 10. Is this much clear, class? Perfect. Now, if I solve this, it will come something like this. Correct? xx will get cancelled. 5 1s are, 5 2s are is 10. So, what is left in the bracket? 5x is outside, x minus 2. So, x minus 2 will be written like this. So, the two factors of 5x square minus 10x will be 5x and x minus 2. Is this clear? Next we have 3x square y minus 6xy square plus 9xy. Okay, if we see the common monomial over here will be 3xy. Okay, so we will divide all the three terms by 3xy. Now 3 will get cancelled. yy will get cancelled, 1x will be cancelled from x square, so what will be left? Only x. In the second term, 3 1s are, 3 2s are, correct? xx will get cancelled, y will get cancelled with the square, so what is remaining? 2y, correct? So I will get 2y. Now 9xy upon 3xy. xy, xy cancel. 3 1s are, 3 3s are is 9. So what will be left? 3. Is this much clear? So we can say over here that x square y minus 6 xy square plus 9 xy is 3 xy and x minus 2y plus 3. Let's proceed. Now we will see factorization by grouping. Okay, how we can factorize by grouping? So the three steps for that are arranging all the terms of the given expression in a suitable group. We will bring the similar terms together. Okay, then factorize each group, take out the factor which is common to each group. Let us see with an example. If I have ax minus bx plus ay minus by. Okay, so we will group. We will bring the xx terms together. So we will get ax minus bx will be one group plus ay minus by. Okay, now from ax minus bx, x is common. So x will come out, inside the bracket you will have a minus b. Again ay minus by, y will be common, so we have a minus b. Now if you check this two term, a minus b is common. So a minus b we will take out and what is left? X plus y. So the factors of ax minus by plus ay minus by is a minus b and x plus y. Similarly, we can do is another way, instead of taking xx as a group, we can take aa as a group. So ax plus ay will come together, minus bx minus by will come together. A will be common, so inside the bracket we will get x plus y. Minus b will be common, so again we will get x plus y. Now x plus y is common, so that will be one bracket and second bracket will be a minus b. In both the case you will get the answer. Next we have factorization of difference of two squares. If we have two squares, how we can factorize? Okay, say for example, x square minus y square. Now we know that x plus y and x minus y will be equal to x square minus y square. So we can say that difference of the squares of the two terms is equal to sum of the two terms by their difference. Same thing we will do over here. We have 25a square minus 36b square. 25a square, 25 root is 5. So we can write it as 5a the whole square. 36b square can be written as 6b the whole square. Now this is my a term, this is my b term. Okay, a square minus b square, answer is a plus b, a minus b. So we will get 5a plus 6a and 5a minus 6b. Let us see two more examples for this. 1 minus 4 a minus 2b square. Okay, 1 minus 4 can be written as 1 minus 2 square and a minus 2b the whole square. Okay, now this 2 is square, so we will take it inside. So what it will be? 2 into a minus 2b whole square. 2 into a, what I will get? 2a, and 2 into 2b I will get 4b. So 2a minus 4b the whole square. 1 can be written as 1 square because 1 root is 1, 1 square is 1. Now I have a square minus b square. So it will be 1 plus 2a minus 4b and 1 minus 2a minus 4b. But 2a minus 4b will be inside the bracket. So we will put a bar bracket over it. If we open that bar bracket, we will get 1 plus 2a minus 4b and 1 minus 2a plus 4b. Let us see one more example. 9x plus y square minus 16x minus 3y square. 9 means 3 square. So I can write 3 inside the bracket x plus y the whole square. 16 is square of 4, so we can write 4 inside the bracket x minus 3y the whole square. After opening the bracket, we will get 3x plus 3y and 4x minus 12y. So this is a square minus b square. It will be 3x plus 3y plus 4x minus 12y. But 3x plus 3y will be inside the bracket and 4x minus 12y will be inside the bracket. So we will use the bar brackets over here. Next, 3x plus 3y minus 4x minus 12y. Again, inside the bar brackets. If we open the bar bracket for the first term, it will remain as it is. 3x plus 3y plus 4x minus 12y. For the second one, because of this minus sign, the sign inside will change. So minus 4x plus 12y. Now we can add xx terms, we can add yy terms. So 3x plus 4x, you will get 7x. 3y minus 12y, you will get minus 9y. Same way, 3x minus 4x, you will get minus x. And 3y plus 12y, you will get 15y. So your answer will be 7x minus 9y, 15y minus x. Let us see how we can factorize a trinomial. Okay. Now, since the product of two binomials will be a trinomial. Okay. Say for example, 2a plus b, 3a minus 5b. If we multiply, we will get 6a square minus 7ab minus 5b square. So, when we want to factor, if we factorize a trinomial, we will get two binomials. So, let us see how to find out the two numbers whose product and sum are given. Okay, before doing this, we need to understand this part. Okay, now let us see. Find the numbers whose product is 6 and sum is 5. So, we need to find two such numbers whose product is 6 and sum is 5. If I say product is 6, sum is 5. Okay, by trial and error, we will find out that 3 and 2 are such numbers because 3 plus 2 is 5 and 3 into 2 is 6. Same way when I say product is 6, sum is minus 5. So, if I say sum is minus 5, product is 6. So, it will be minus 3 minus 2, but sum is minus 5. So, we will get the answer as minus 3 minus 2. Next, my product is minus 6 and sum is 5. My sum is 5 and product is minus 6. So, if we do the permutation and combination, we will get the two numbers as 6 and minus 1. Because 6 minus 1, 6 plus minus 1, you will get the answer as 5. And 6 into minus 1, you will get the product as minus 6. Same way, when I have minus 6 as the product and minus 5 as the number, my sum, then my numbers will be minus 6 and 1. Because minus 6 into 1, I will get the product as minus 6. And minus 6 plus 1, I will get the answer as minus 5. Got it? If we know that if I have a product and sum, I can find numbers, we will use this in finding the factors of a trinomial. Now, this way, this method is known as splitting the middle term method. Okay. First thing, you have to write the trinomial in the descending order of their powers. Means if it is 6x square plus 11x plus 3. So, we will write it either in the descending order. So, x square will be written first. Then you will have 11x. Then 3. If I am writing in this ascending order, it will be 3 plus 11x plus 6x square. Okay. Now, find the product of the first and the last term of the trinomial with signs. In case of 6x square plus 11x plus 3, the product of its first and the last term, that is 6x square and 3, will be 18x square. Correct? So, first thing you have to find the product of first and last term. So, 6x square plus 3, you will get 18x square. Now, we have to split the middle term of the given trinomial, that is 11x, such that the sum of the two numbers that you will obtain should be equal to 11x and product should be equal to 18x square. Is that clear? The sum should be equal to the middle term and product should be equal to the product of first and last term. So, by trial and error, we will get the answer as 9x and 2x because 9x into 2x is 11x, 9x plus 2x is 11x and 9x into 2x, you will get 18x square. So, we will split the middle term as 9x and 2x. Now, if you check first one, 3x square plus 9x, 3x is common because 3x into 2, you will get 6x square, 3x into 2x, you will get 6x square. And 3x into 3, you will get 9x. Okay, so I will take out 3x as common. In the bracket, you will get 2x plus 3. Same way, if I take in this If I check, nothing is common. So I will take 1 as a common and you will get 2x plus 3. Now if you check first two, these two terms, 2x plus 3, 2x plus 3 is common. So that will be written as a bracket as 2x plus 3 and other two terms you will get 3x plus 1. Let us see few more examples. First trinomial is given as x square minus 9x plus 20. First thing, whether it is in ascending or descending order, yes, it is in descending order. So multiply first and last term. So if I multiply first and last term, x square into 20, I will get 20x square. When I get 20x square, so my product should be 20x square and my sum should be minus 9x. By permutation and combination, I will get the two numbers minus 5x minus 4x, because minus 5 into minus 4, I will get minus 9x, and multiplying them, I will get 5 4 is 20x square. So I will split the middle term as minus 5x minus 4x. If you take check the first two term, I can take x as common, so I will get x minus 5. The second two terms, I will take minus 4 common, I will get x minus 5. If you see x minus 5 common, that will be my one bracket. X minus 4 will be my another bracket. So the two factors of x square minus 9 square plus 20 is x minus 5, x minus 4. Similarly, y square plus 5y minus 24. First thing is find the product of the first two terms, first and last term. So first term is y square, last term is minus 24. So y square into minus 24, I will get minus 24y square. And middle term is 5y. So addition of the two terms should be equal to 5y and product should be minus 24y square. By permutation and combination, I get the two numbers, two terms as 8y and 3y. Okay, 8y and 3y. Now 8y into minus 3y, you will get the sum as plus 5y, and 8y into minus 3y, you will get the answer as minus 24. We'll split the middle term 8y minus 3y. I can take y common, so inside the bracket I will get y plus 8 minus 3 common, so y plus 8. Y plus 8 will be my one bracket and y minus 3 will be my another bracket. Similarly, you can solve the third one. Let us see few more examples. A plus b square minus 11ab minus 24. Okay. Now, for solving such equations, ab will be taken as x. Okay, so we can take ab as an x, denoted by x. Okay, so our solving becomes easier. So this will become x square minus 11x minus 42. Now, this equation becomes similar to the sums that we have solved initially. So same way we will solve. Product of first and last term, x square into 24x. So you will get 24x square, 42, sorry. 42x square should be your product and sum should be 11x. So if I split, I will get the answer as minus 14x plus 3x, because minus 14 plus 3, I will get minus 11, and 14 threes are, you will get 42. So again, x will be common. So x minus 14 will remain inside, 3 common. So x minus 14 will be inside. Then if we solve further, you will get x minus 14 common, x plus 3 will be in one bracket. Now instead of x, we will substitute the value, that is a plus b. So our factors will become a plus b minus 14, a plus b plus 3. Similarly, we can solve the second one. In the second one, x minus y will be taken as, say, a. Okay, so instead of x minus y, we will put a. So the equation will become 7 plus 10a minus 8a square. Now this is similar to the sums that we were solving. So again, product of two, first and last, 7 8s are 56, correct? So now product should be 56 and sum should be 10. So we will get the answer as plus 14 minus 4. Because 14 minus 4, I will get 10, and 14 into 4, I will get 56. So I will split the middle term as 14a minus 4a. Now, from this first two terms, 7 will be common, so I will get 1 plus 2a. From the second two terms, I will take minus 4a common, so I will get 1 plus 2a. 1 plus 2a will be my one bracket, second bracket will be 7 minus 4a. Substituting the value of a as x minus y, I will get the factors as 1 plus 2 into x minus y, 7 minus 4 into x minus y. Now, opening the bracket, I will get 1 plus 2x minus 2y, 7 minus 4x plus 4y. Next, we have factorization of perfect square trinomial. When I say perfect square, if it is a plus b the whole square, the formula is a square plus 2ab plus b square. Same way, a minus b the whole square, the formula is a square minus 2ab plus b square. Okay. So, if I say the equation is in terms of a square plus 2ab plus b square, then they are known as perfect square. Say for example, 4x square plus 12x plus 9y square. So, 4 can be written as 2x square. Correct? 9 can be written as 3y square. Correct? So, 2x the whole square, 3y the whole square. Middle term is 2 into a into b. That is 2 into 2x into 3y. Is that clear? So, that way we will get 12y. So, this is in the term of a square plus 2ab plus b square. So, my answer will be a plus b the whole square. So, a is 2a. And b is 3y. So, factor of this will be 2a plus 3y the whole square. Now, let us see how we can factorize completely. Okay. Say for example, factorize completely 3x square minus 18xy. Okay. So, 8x cube minus 18xy square. Okay. So, we can take 2x as common. So, this will become 4x square minus 9y square. Correct? Now, 4x square can be written as 2x the whole square. 9y square can be written as 3y the whole square. So, if I factorize, I will get 2x as one term, 2x plus 3y as another term, and 2x minus 3y as another term, because a square minus b square, the formula is a plus b, a minus b. Similarly, for the second one, I can take 3 as common. So, I will get x square plus 4y minus 12. So, when we say complete factorization, we have to see from in the given trinomial if there is anything which is coming common. So, we will take that out as a common. So, we will get total 3 factors over here. Now, if I say 3 into 2x square plus 6x minus 2x plus minus 12. Now, over here, this was not a perfect square. So, we used splitting the middle term method. Again, x will be common. You will get x plus 6 minus 2 will be common. You will get x plus 6. So, the common bracket is x plus 6 and another bracket will be x minus 2. So, the factors will be 3, x plus 6, x minus 2. Is this much clear, class? Let us see one example based on it. X square plus 4xy plus 4y square minus 9z square. Okay. Now, if you see the equation, that is x square plus 4xy plus 4y square, it is of the type a square plus 2ab plus b square. So, the factor will be x plus 2y the whole square. And next term which is left is 9z square. So, 9z square will be written as 3z square. 3z the whole square. So, the factors, if I solve, we will get it as x plus 2y the whole square minus 3z the whole square. Okay. Now, this is in the term a square minus b square. So, the final answer will be x plus 2y plus 3z because a plus b into a minus b, that is x plus 2y minus 3z. Next, we have 16x raised to 4 minus y raised to 4. 16x raised to 4 can be written as 4x square the whole square. Y raised to 4 can be written as y square the whole square. That will be 4x square plus y square 4x square minus y square. Now 4x square minus y square can be written as 2x the whole square minus y square. This is in the term a square minus b square. So factorizing, we will get 2x plus y and 2x minus y. So final answer will be 4x square plus y square into 2x plus y into 2x minus y. Everything is clear. Thank you so much for watching this video.